Now, in this case, we're going to talk about respiratory distress as it affects the lower airway. And conditions such as asthma, bronchiolitis, cause an obstruction of the lower airway in the lower trachea, the bronchi, or the bronchioles. Now, in contrast to upper airway obstructions, lower airway obstructions are typically more apparent during the expiratory phase of the respiration cycle. Like wheezing, most commonly, is on expiration, and a prolonged expiration that takes more effort may be often recognized as retractions, nasal flaring, and an active process of attempting to blow the air out of their lungs. Coughing is also quite typical with this lower respiratory distress. Now, with infants, the respiratory rate increases. When a lower airway obstruction worsens, inspiratory retractions become more noticeable as the respiratory effort becomes more difficult. Lung disease can also appear as a lower airway obstruction. Lung disease causes a child's lungs to become stiff. Increased effort during inspiration and expiration is often identified by retractions and accessory muscle use due to the accumulation of fluid or inflammation in the alveoli or interstitium. Because small airways in the lower lungs collapse, we might even see grunting respirations, as they're often present as a result of the increased respiratory efforts. Now, just as with upper airway obstruction, early recognition, identification, and the treatment of respiratory distress in infants and children is extremely vital. Respiratory distress can quickly progress to respiratory failure and cardiac arrest. Treatment begins with placing the patient in the best position of comfort that keeps the airway open and helps support breathing efforts. Usually keeping the head of the bed elevated is your best option for sitting the child up. Next, check the lung sounds and apply an oxygen saturation monitor while the patient's still on room air. High flow oxygen should then be started right away for respiratory distress. The goal is to keep the oxygen saturation again above 94%. After initial oxygen therapy is established, assessment of a good blood pressure, pulse, respiratory rate, their temperature, and a good ECG should all follow. Identify and treat the specific lower airway obstruction as needed based on the signs and the symptoms the patient's exhibiting. And if the patient's condition is asthma, treatment would include a nebulizer with 2.5 milligrams of albuterol and possible administration of corticosteroids. If the patient's condition is bronchiolitis, then suctioning and the oral and the nasal passages as needed would be your best treatment. Assess the need for further treatment by considering laboratory and other tests, like viral studies, a chest x-ray, and arterial blood gas. Once the patient is stabilized, medical consultation for effective and ongoing managed definitive care should be initiated.